In this video, I'm going to be showing you a comparison of AppGyver to Bubble. You're going to be learning four things in this video. Number one, the features. Number two, the pricing. Number three, the marketplaces. Number four, we're going to be looking at the two communities. And at the end of the video, I'm going to show you which one I would choose. What is AppGyver? AppGyver is a platform where you can build apps in all different forms. Desktop, mobile, browser, TV, it doesn't really matter. It allows you to use a drag and drop interface to create different elements on the app. This really nice visual builder that allows you to build out logic for your app. And you can bring in data from all different types of sources. This is really powerful because now you can start integrating different databases from your favorite locations and make this app even more powerful. Additionally, you can publish this app on several different platforms. One of their claims to fame would definitely be working with bigger corporations such as DHL, and this is a well-recognized brand, and they use this to create an app for their business. What is Bubble? Bubble is a platform where you can use a drag-and-drop editor to create pretty much anything, and I mean almost anything with Bubble. Bubble allows you to visually build an app, and you can use many different components to do this. You can use their drag-and-dropper, also their dynamic content that you can have for this app. It's pretty amazing using this. I also like how you can really watch how people are using your application and have the insights to really change the app the way that you need it. If you're building out and you have a team, we got you. This platform allows you to work in teams and really start scaling your operations as well. If I'm looking at features, Bubble and AppGyver both have very robust capabilities with their platforms. I would say that Bubble has it more built out, especially with their community, and we'll talk about that later, but you can see a lot more case studies in their community and talking with different ones using Bubble. AppGyver does have a lot of capabilities, but there's a lot less examples, especially online or in their community, to really see how you could be using this for your specific use case. Let's talk about pricing. I get this question all the time in the comments, so let's just get right to it. What makes AppGyver special? Drum roll, please. That's right. It's free until your organization is making $10 million. That's kind of free for free. That allows your side hustle to really scale and move with purpose when you don't have to worry about, okay, am I going to lose this next feature or when do I have to upgrade to get this next feature? The Composer is free until $10 million. Bubble, on the other hand, is free to get started, but there are several different tiers that cost money. The free plan, you can get started right now. It's free, but you would have the branding of Bubble. So there, it depends on what you're trying to do. But I would really look at the personal and professional plan. Now, why would I do this? Because once you go to the professional plan, now I can start using the core platform and the APIs. So if we're not familiar with APIs, that just allows different systems to talk to one another. This is huge for Bubble. There are so many things you can be using Bubble for. Palterion, the list goes on and on, but this is crucial. I see a lot of Bubble builders using this feature. Also, too, there's going to be probably a link down below. Our boy Stephen Campbell that used AI GPT-3 with his project and created his own micro SaaS, a software as a service, using Bubble in GPT-3. Again, he started with just the personal plan and then went from there. So there are serious companies that are using Bubble with the personal plan. What are some of the drawbacks? Again, if people are looking at the bang for your buck or pricing, also to note, the personal plan allows you to have white labeling capacity. So that's a huge thing that I would be looking towards to really build out my app or my business. The file storage goes up tremendously. We now have 10 gig if we go for the personal plan. That's usually where we see a lot of builders start at. Okay, so who takes the pricing? It kind of really depends on what you're looking for, right? If you do not have any capital right now and you're trying to learn the basics of how to use an editor like this and understand the advancement, I'd probably go with AppGyver if you have no capital to use at all. But Bubble does have so many different types of plugins, resources. When you're building out, it really depends on what you're trying to create. And the community, I keep bringing this up and we'll talk about it later with the community section, it's more robust with Bubble. So where are you right now? That's only what you can answer right now. So in the comment section down below, let me know if pricing is a huge thing for you. Regarding the pricing for Bubble, what I also like is you'll hear certain creators give themselves a timeline. For example, they'll upgrade to the personal account and they'll say, I'll use this only for 30 days. If I don't get my money back or I don't make enough money to cover the cost, I just can't use it anymore. That allows a light of fire under you and it allows you to see, is this a side hustle that is going to be sustainable? If not, maybe learn on a free plan for Bubble or try out AppGyver. And then when you have a validation and you're ready, then committing a month at a time or giving yourself some kind of runway in order to do so. Let's talk about the marketplaces. Bubble and AppGyver both have marketplaces, but there are some noticeable differences. If we look at Bubble, we have templates, plugins, and also agencies available to help us with our apps. They're pretty robust, and some range from being free, and some you can just buy to start using for your projects. One of the key takeaways I would look at for Bubble is the level of plugins that they have. There are so many different types. Ones from Airtable, Facebook, Google Sign In. There's ones for Pelterion. The list goes on and on. The plugins are ridiculous. Looking at the marketplace for AppGyver, there's a little bit of a difference. The marketplace on AppGyver is very, very limited. There are still some for front-end logic, back-end logic, pages, all of those things, but it is limited. With the Composer Pro 3, it is very limited. There is still a marketplace, but it's nowhere near the scope of Bubble. Now let's talk about what I've been hinting at all along, the community. This is what makes the difference I see with Bubble and AppGyver. The Bubble community is insane. They have more than 1 million bubblers, and the message board is crazy with so many different use cases. People are really, really helpful, and people make tons of tutorials online how to use Bubble. Versus AppGyver, the community is still there, but it's not as active, and the use cases are sparse. So you have to really take the key components, what you see in the community, and then use it for your own project. I would like to say the AppGyver documentation is really nice. It's very concise and you can learn a lot from it. But again, the use cases or your own nuance cases, it's just not usually there. So you're going to have to look at what is provided and then really do some digging. Now that we've looked at both Bubble and AppGyver, which one would I pick? And the answer is, it depends. No, the answer, I would go with Bubble. And the reason behind it is, if I'm trying to move fast, I want to have the most options possible. I would use the plugins that Bubble provides. Their community is crazy, and it's just really, really good. AppGyver does have a place, and I think if you're trying to get started and you have no capital to put towards your project, I think AppGyver can get you started, but you are going to run into some kind of limitations because you won't see the exact kind of use case, perhaps, versus Bubble. There are hundreds, if not thousands, of projects you can look at right now, see the showcase, see what they're doing, and then apply it right into your project. With complexity, I would actually put them pretty neck and neck. They're pretty similar. Now, they're different workflows, so you can't just be an AppGyver and then think you can just be in Bubble and know what you're talking about, or vice versa. But the complexity, they're about on the same level. So just to keep that in mind, if we're looking at the spectrum of like no-code tools, the easeability, like Card and software would be on one set, which would be super easy. The harder aspect would be definitely Bubble and AppGyver on the opposite side. That being the case, it allows you to have critical thinking, really think about logically how you're developing these apps, and then going from there. In the comment section below, let me know what you're trying to use your app for. Where are you in your process? Are you just thinking about an app, thinking about a problem to solve, or are you on a platform and you're deciding which one you should go stay on long term to expand your project? And if you're liking content like this, make sure that you either hit subscribe or like this video. I'll see you in the next video.